Good evening students, welcome back to online maths class. So in today's class I'll be discussing about allied angles and its significance, where exactly we are going to make use of the concept called allied angles. So in our earlier classes we have given the standard table for all the angles, we have listed all the six trigonometric ratios and their values for all the standard angles. Now if the question is find the value of tan 135 degree, then or the question could be sine 120 degree or secant 225 degree or secant 225 degree or cos 150 degree or cos 150 degree. So how do you find the values of all these cases? In order to find such values, we have to go for the concept called allied angles. So to understand this concept, you should have a strong basics about the ASTC rule and the quadrants. So now let us discuss about what are allied angles and what are the examples of the allied angles. So see here, the definition says if two angles are such that their sum or difference, their sum andre koodisbeku, difference mean andre kaliyodu, their sum or difference is 0 or multiple of 90 degree, their sum or difference is either 0 or multiple of 90 degree, then they are called allied angles. Andre yavde angle the sum either 0 or irbeku illa multiple of 90 or irbeku. Multiple of 90 andre yavudre 90, 180, 270, 360 and so on. So if that is the answer, then such angles are called the allied angles. So let me give the examples. So here the examples for allied angles are, first case 30 degree comma 60 degree. I have taken two angles now, 30 degree and 60 degree. So take the sum of these two angles, what we get? 30 plus 60, it will be 90. So the sum is going to be 90 degree here. The sum is 90 degrees. Now let us take one more example. So one more example will be 225 degree and then 45 degree. 225 degree and then 45 degree. So here if you take the sum you get 270 degree. If you take the sum you get 270 degree. In case if you take the difference you get 180 degree. 180 degree. So observe these three cases here, observe these three examples. So here 90 can be written as 90 degree into 1, it is a multiple of 90. So here 270, 90 degree into 3. So here 180, 90 degree into 2. So all these three angles are multiples of 90 degree. All these angles are multiples of 90 degree. That is why these angles are called allied angles. 30 degree, 60 degree, 225 degree and then 45 degree. Then another example could be 120 degree and then 30 degree. 120 degree and then 30 degree. What we have to do here? So here we will have to take the difference of these two angles. So 120 minus 30, it will be 90 degree. So we will have to go for the difference. So it is 90 degrees. So these angles 120 degree and 30 degree are the allied angles. So here I have taken the particular examples. Let us give some of the general examples. So here first one, 90 degree plus theta and then theta. 90 degree plus theta, theta I have taken. So now here if you take the difference of these two, we get the answer as 90 degree. So let us take the difference. What we get now? 90 degree, 90 degree plus theta and then minus theta. Plus theta, minus theta get cancels. We get the answer as 90 degrees. So here 90 plus theta and theta are allied angles. Then let us give one more example. 180 degree minus theta then theta. 180 degree minus theta, then theta. So here we should not subtract, we have to add these two angles. So I'm going for the addition process. So we have to take the sum, 180 degree minus theta plus theta, 180 degree minus theta plus theta. So here minus theta plus theta get cancels, get the answer as 180 degrees. So again, this pair is an example for allied angles. So this is all about the basics of the allied angles. Let us go for the next concept. Well, so here I have taken two cases of the XY plane or the Cartesian planes. So in the previous class, we have discussed about the quadrants and the AHTC rule. So here, this on the x-axis, either we get the 0 degree or the 360 degree. This is the basic information. Then on the y-axis, so here you get the 90 degrees. Here we get the 90 degrees. Here we get 180 degree. Here you get 180 degree. And then, so here we get 270 degree. Here you get 270 degrees. So this is the first quadrant. And this is the second quadrant. This is the second quadrant. Now this is the third quadrant. And this will be the fourth quadrant. Now the question is, what are the angles that we get in the first quadrant? So first quadrant alli bartakanta angles yav? So nodirli, 360 ginta jaasti irudu amele 90 ginta kadme irudu. The angles which are greater than 360 degree and less than 90 degree falls in the, you know, first quadrant. So here what angles we get? 90 degree minus theta, 90 degree minus theta, and then theta is some angle, and 360 degree plus, so 360 plus theta. So these two angles falls in the first quadrant. Now come to the second quadrant. So in the second quadrant, the angle must be greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So it has to be 90 degree plus theta, 90 degree plus theta, and what is the other one? 180 degree minus theta, 180 minus theta. Now come to the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, which angle we get now? 180 greater than 180, less than 270. Andra 180 ginta jaasti irudu amele 270 ginta kadme irudu. So 180 ginta jaasti andra 180 plus theta baribodri, 180 degree plus theta, and less than 270 means we can write 270 degree minus theta. So here we get 180 degree plus theta, we get 180 degree plus theta, and then 270 degree minus theta. So 270 degree minus theta. Now come to the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, so what are the angles we get? Greater than 270 and less than 360. So it has to be 270 degree plus theta, and then 360 degree minus theta. So 0 degree or 360 degree, one and the same. So now I'll be naming the quadrants. So this is the first quadrant, this is the second quadrant, this is the third quadrant, and this is the fourth quadrant. So this is the basic information. And in the previous class, we have studied that all the trigonometric ratios are positive in the first quadrant. In the second quadrant, only sine and cosec. In the third quadrant, tan and cot. In the fourth quadrant, cos and secant. So let us write that information now. So here, in the first quadrant, all positive. All positive. Then here in the second quadrant, sin x and cosecant x, if you take the angle x, in case if you take the angle as theta, sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. Here remaining trigonometric ratios will be negative. So here only these two are positive. Then in the third quadrant, AST, in the third quadrant, tan x and cot x, these two are positive, remaining will be negative. So here cos x, here cos x and its reciprocal secant x, both are positive, both are positive. So this is the first quadrant, this is the second quadrant, and this is the third quadrant, and this is the fourth quadrant. So here all positive, here sine and, you know, cosecant positive, here tan and cot, tan and its reciprocal, cot are positive, here cos and secant are positive. So this is the basic information that we have discussed in the previous class. So now with the help of this, now we are going to list out some of the standard, you know, properties that you will have to remember. So see here, first one, I'll be taking 90 degree minus theta. For 90 degree minus theta, we have to write all the six trigonometric ratios, and again after that I'll be going for 90 plus theta, 180 minus theta, 180 plus theta, 270 minus theta, 270 plus theta, and 360 minus theta, and then 360 plus theta. So let us go discuss one by one in the beginning. So before going for listing out those properties, here we have an important conversions. So see here, so we have the important rule here. When we have the angles 90 degree and 270 degree in the trigonometric ratios in the form of 90 plus theta, 90 minus theta, 270 plus theta and 270 minus theta, we have to do the following conversions. So whenever you get these four cases, 90 degree plus or minus theta, I have taken both, and then 270 degree plus or minus theta, e cases bandaga certain rule aitre, so we have to follow that rule. See here, whenever you get these cases, so the rule says sine x changes to cos x. So sin x changes to cos x and cos x changes to sin x. That is why I have considered double arrow mark. If sin is changing to cos, means I could have written, or I would have written only this one, sin x changes to cos x. So here I am considering the double arrow mark. So sin x must be changed to cos x and cos x must be changed to sin x. Then the next one. So tan x will be changed to, tan x will be changed to cot x. Tan x will be changed to cot x. Then secant x will be changed to cosecant x. Secant x will be changed into cosecant x, and vice versa. So these are the functions and these are the cofunctions. So sine, the cofunction of the cosine, adike name cosine antirutha, sine and cosine. Then tan means tangent. What is cot? It is cotangent. Andre tan the cofunction andre cot agutirili. Then secant x and its cofunction will be cosecant x. So whenever we have the angles 90 degree and 270 degree in the trigonometric ratios in the form, in the trigonometric ratios means, whenever you get this case, sine 90 degree plus theta, sine 90 degree plus theta, or tan 270 minus theta, tan 270 minus theta. So whenever we get 90 plus theta, 90 minus theta, 270 plus theta, 270 minus theta in trigonometric ratios, so we have to do this particular conversion. Sine must be changed to cos and tan must be changed to cot, or cos x must be changed to sin x. This is the rule you will have to remember. So now think about the other case. So what could be the other case? So in case when we have the angles 180 degree and 360 degree, so we are done with the 90. See here, we are done with the 90. So here we get 90 degree and here you get 270 degree. Now which are angles left out now? 180 and 360. 360 are 0 degree, one is the same. So when we have the angles 180 degree and 360 degree, in trigonometric ratios in the form of 180 plus or minus theta, 180 degree plus or minus theta, and 360 degree plus or minus theta. So here we are not going to do any changes. The sine x remains sine x and cos x remains cos x. All the trigonometric ratios remains same. So that is the rule you will have to follow. So here only I'll be writing. In case of 180 degree plus or minus theta, 180 degree plus or minus theta, and 360 degree plus or minus theta, 360 plus theta or 360 minus theta. So what we get now, sine x remains sine x. Sine x remains sine x, it will not change. In case if we have 90 minus 90 plus, sine x must be changed to cos x. So now similarly, tan x remains tan x, and then cos x remains cos x, and so on. And we have to write the remaining three cases. So for 180 plus or minus theta and 360 degree plus or minus theta, so we don't get any changes. So in case if we have this case, we are going to have these particular changes. So with this important conversions, I'll be going for the listing out the important properties. So let us list out one by one now. Well, so in the first case, I'll be taking 90 degree minus theta, that already you have studied in your 10th standard. Puraka kona galatva complementary angles anta study madiri. So now I'll be taking sine 90 degree minus theta, and then cos 90 degree minus theta, then tan 90 degree minus theta, and then cot 90 degree minus theta, and then secant 90 degree minus theta, and then cosecant 90 degree minus theta. So now see here, you have 90 minus theta. So in the previous case, we have discussed it. Whenever you have 90 minus theta, sine x must be changed to cos x and cos x must be changed to sine x. So here, sine 90 degree minus theta, it will be cos theta. This is equals to cos theta. What we have done? Sine must be changed to cos. Now we have cos. Cos 90 minus theta. Cos must be changed to sine. So it must be changed to sine. One second. So it must be changed to sine theta. Then now tan 90 degree minus theta. Tan 90 minus theta becomes cot theta. So function has to change to cofunction cot theta. Then cot 90 minus theta, it will be tan theta. Then secant 90 minus theta, it has to be cosecant theta. Cosecant theta, and cosecant 90 minus theta, it will be secant theta. So here, see the second column. Here all the trigonometric ratios are positive. Why? So look at this now. Yes. 90 degree minus theta. 90 degree minus theta means it is there in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, all the trigonometric ratios are positive. All the trigonometric ratios will be positive in the first quadrant. That is why I have written all positive in the second column. That is why I have written all positive in the second column. So this is the first set. So this is going to be the first set of properties. Like this, we get 8 set of properties. So this you already studied in your 10th standard. Now we'll go for 90 plus theta and let us see what happens. So the second set, it is sine साइन 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा, साइन 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा, देन कॉस 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा एंड देन टैन 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा एंड देन सीकेंट 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा देन कोसेकेंट 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा सो इदे आर्डर द बरीबेक अंत एनिल्ल चेंजेस आदरू नडीतदे एंड देन कॉट कॉट 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा कॉट 90 डिग्री प्लस थीटा 90 प्लस थीटा मीन्स साइन मस्ट बी चेंज्ड टू कॉस एंड कॉस मस्ट बी चेंज्ड टू साइन अंदर फंक्शन इरोदु को फंक्शन आगबेकु को फंक्शन इरोदु फंक्शन आगबेकु दिस इज द फर्स्ट रूल एंड देन व्हाट इज द सेकंड रूल 90 प्लस थीटा अंदर याव क्वाड्रेंट आगुत्त नोड्री टिल हियर इट इज 90 डिग्री टिल हियर इट इज 90 डिग्री 90 प्लस मीन्स इट फॉल्स इन द सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट इन द सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट व्हिच ऑल द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस आर पॉजिटिव इन द सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट ओनली साइन and its reciprocal that is cosecant only these two are positive in the second quadrant remaining will be negative remaining ratios are going to be negative so what is the first rule now so since we have the 90 plus sin must be changed to cos so this is equals to I'll be writing cos theta and then cos must be written to cos must be changed to sin theta then next tan must be changed to cot theta and secant must be changed to cosecant theta function irudhu co function aagbeku co function irudhu function aagbeku so cosecant theta becomes secant theta and then cot 90 plus theta means tan theta ಹೌದ್ರೆ so this is the basic thing ಅಂದ್ರೆ first rule ಅಷ್ಟೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿವಿ now second rule in the second quadrant only sin and cosecant ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡಬೇಕು ಈಗ ನೀವು sin ಮತ್ತು cosecant ಇವೆರಡೇ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ remaining ratios will be negative so here I'll be writing plus ಈ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡಬೇಡ್ರೆ So see the first column which are all positive and which are all negative you have the sign yes sign is positive in the first second quadrant whereas its reciprocal cosecant is positive in the second quadrant these remaining ratios will be negative cos is going to be negative in the second quadrant and then tan is going to be negative in the second quadrant then secant it will be negative and then cot it will be negative in the second quadrant this is how you need to write the you know all the properties I hope you are getting these points next I'll be moving on to 180 degree minus theta second quadrant andre innu yavd angle barut nodre till here it is 90 degree and it is 180 degree here second quadrant means it is 90 degree plus theta and 180 degree minus theta we get these two angles in the second quadrant so now I'll be listing out all those ratios you know trigonometric ratios sin 180 degree minus theta sin 180 degree minus theta then cos 180 degree minus theta then tan 180 degree minus theta and then secant 180 degree minus theta then cosecant 180 degree minus theta then secant 180 degree minus theta so we have listed all the trigonometric ratios 180 minus theta means it is the second quadrant it will be the second quadrant in the second quadrant only sin x and cosecant x are positive only sin and cosecant not cosine in the second quadrant only sin and its reciprocal that is cosecant are positive so I'll be writing positive sin here positive sign. Remaining will be negative. So remaining, one second, I will write the equal sign. Yes, so remaining will be negative. All these things will be negative. And you have the one more rule. Whenever you get 180 plus, 180 minus, 360 plus, 360 minus, the function remains as it is. We should not do any changes. So this we have already written. See here, in case of 180 degree plus or minus theta, 360 degree plus or minus theta, sin x remains sin x, tan x remains tan x, and cos x remains cos x. Similarly, cosecant x remains cosecant x. So we should not do any changes now. So now sin remains sin, that means sin theta. So now onwards, what is sin 180 minus theta? It is plus sin theta. And then similarly, cos 180 degree minus theta. 180 minus means it is the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, cos is negative. That is why I have written negative sin. So we have 180 minus. We should not change this one. So we get cos theta. Then tan 180 minus theta. It is minus tan theta. Then secant 180 minus theta, it is minus secant theta. Then cosecant 180 minus theta, it will be plus cosecant theta. Plus cosecant theta. Then secant, so secant already we have written. Now we will have to write cot. Sorry. So this has to be cot 180 minus theta, it will be minus cot theta minus cot theta. I hope you are getting how we are writing all these, you know, angles. So what is the next angle now? We are done with 90 minus, 90 plus, 180 minus. Next it has to be 180 plus and 270 minus. So the next one, it is sine 180 degree plus theta, and then similarly cos 180 degree plus theta, and then tan 180 degree plus theta, and then secant 180 degree plus theta, secant 180 plus theta, and then cosecant 180 degree plus theta, and then cot 180 degree plus theta. So now consider the quadrant. Now 180 plus theta means it is the third quadrant. In the third quadrant we have only tan x or tan theta, and its reciprocal cot theta are positive in the third quadrant. Remaining ratios will be negative. This is the first concept. So that means only tan and cot, only these two are positive, remaining will be negative. Then what is the next rule? We have 180 plus, that means these ratios must be retained as it is. We should not change anything. Sin irodu idu cos agala, cos irodu sin agala. Sin irodu sin e aagutade, cot irodu cot aagutade. We should not do any changes now. So now let us write this. Yes, so which are all positive in the third quadrant? So only tan and cot, only these two are positive. That is why I'll be writing plus sign here. Only these two are positive. Then how about the remaining? Remaining will be negative. Remaining will be negative. I am writing minus sign. Then since you have 180 plus theta, we should not do any changes. Sine means we will have to write sine theta. Then here cos theta, and then here tan theta, and then secant theta, and then here cosecant theta, and then here cot theta. So this is the, you know, fourth list. So now onwards, tan 180 degree plus theta means it is the tan theta. This is the, you know, property. Or secant 180 plus theta, it will be minus secant theta. sin 180 plus theta. 180 plus means it is the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, sin is negative. That is why we have written minus sin theta. Well, we are done with this. Next, which is the next table now? So this third quadrant is nothing but 180 plus theta and 270 degree minus theta. So the next table must be 270 degree minus theta. Well, so I'll be writing this table now. Sine 270 degree minus theta, sine 270 degree minus theta, and then cos 270 degree minus theta, and then tan 270 degree minus theta, and then secant 270 degree minus theta, then cosecant 270 degree minus theta, then cot 270 degree minus theta. So again, see the rule here. What was the rule? Yes, whenever we have 270 plus theta and 270 minus theta, so this is going to be the conversion. Now sine must be changed to cos, that means function will be changed to cofunction, or cofunction will be changed to function. So this rule we will have to use. So let us go for the 270 minus table. Yes, so here sine we have, that means it has to be changed to cos. So later we'll write the plus or minus sign. So it has to be cos x. Then here cos, it has to be sine, because we have 270 minus. Then function must be changed to cofunction. Tan, it will be cot, we get cot x. Then we have secant, it has to be cosecant. Then cosecant, it has to be secant. Then we have cot, it has to be tan. Yes, now think about the sign, which are going to be positive and which are going to be negative. So 270 minus means obviously it will be the third quadrant. This is 270, this is 180. So 270 minus means less than 270, 270 in the kadme iro angle. So it falls in the third quadrant. This is going to be 270 degree minus theta. In the third quadrant, only tan x and cot x are positive. Only these two are positive, remaining will be negative. So what I will do, only for tan I'll put the plus sign, and for cot here last one I'll put the plus sign. Remaining will be negative. So these are all negative. So this is simple. This is how you need to write the table. So what is the next table now? Now we have to move beyond 270. The next angle must be 270 plus theta, and after that we get 360 degree minus theta. So let us go for the next one. Well, the next one, sine 270 degree plus theta, then cos 270 degree plus theta, then tan 270 degree plus theta, then secant 270 degree plus theta, then we have cosecant, then we have cosecant 270 degree plus theta, then cot 270 degree plus theta, then cot 270 degree plus theta. Yes, Now 270 plus means it is the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, which are all the positive and which are all negative? Only cos and its reciprocal secant will be positive. Only cos x and secant x are positive, remaining will be negative in the fourth quadrant. And here we have 270 plus. Andre sin irod cos agbeku, cos irod sin agbeku. Overall function must be changed to cofunction and cofunction must be changed to function. So sin theta, that means it has to be cos theta. Later we'll think about the sin. It has to be cos theta. Then here cos means we will have to write sin theta. Then next we have tan theta. It has to be cot theta. Then next secant theta means it should be cosecant theta. Then we have cosecant theta. It has to be secant theta. Then we have cot theta. It should be tan theta. It should be tan theta. Now think about the sign, which are all positive and which are all negative. So we are in the fourth quadrant now. Only cos and its reciprocal secant, only these two must be positive. So here I'll be writing plus sign, and here I'll be writing plus sign. Remaining will be negative. So for remaining, you just have to write the minus sign. Let us write the minus sign. So it is minus cos theta, minus cot theta, minus secant theta, minus tan theta. So now onwards, tan 270 degree plus theta means it is minus cot theta, and then cosecant 270 degree plus theta, it is minus secant theta. So you will have to remember all these formulas. Yes, what will be the next one? 270 plus is over. Now the next one should be what is that? 360 minus. So the next one should be 360 minus sine 360 degree minus theta. Sine 360 degree minus theta, that means it is the fourth quadrant. And then cos 360 degree minus theta, then tan 360 degree minus theta, and then secant 360 degree minus theta, and then cosecant 360 degree minus theta, and then cot 360 degree minus theta. So 360 minus means it is the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, only cos and secant will be positive, remaining will be negative. So 360 minus 360 minus andra the function remains as it is, sine remains sine and cos remains cos. So now this is equals to, so here since we have 360 minus, sine must be written as it is, sine must be written as it is, then cos theta, then here what we have, tan theta, then secant theta, then you have cosecant theta, then the last one it is cot theta. Now in the fourth quadrant, only cos and secant are positive, so I'll be writing plus sign. Only these two are positive, remaining will be negative. So write the minus sign for the remaining. So now onwards, what is sine 360 degree minus theta? It is minus sine theta. And cos 360 degree minus theta, it will be plus cos theta. So this is the table you will have to remember. And then we all know that, we all know that 360 degree and 0 degree are same. 360 360 degree and 0 degree or yes, we all know that 360 degree and 0 degree are same. So now in place of 360 degree, can we write 0 degree? Yes, we can write 0 degree. In place of 360 degree, I can replace 0 degree now. So 0 minus theta, 0 minus theta, 0 minus x and minus x. Similarly, 0 minus theta means it is minus theta. So now onwards, sine minus theta, sine minus theta, it will be minus sine theta. How did you get this? So in place of 360, I have replaced 0 because 0 degree and 360 degree are one and the same. Now cos 0 minus theta, it will be minus theta. That means cos of minus theta, it will be cos theta. Then what is the next one? Tan minus theta, it will be minus tan theta. Then secant minus theta, it will be secant theta. Plus secant theta. Then cosecant minus theta, it becomes minus cosecant theta. Then cot minus theta, it will be minus cot theta. So this is an important table, again you will have to remember. So now trigonometric functions introduction concept alli iveldu derive madidju now. ಅಂದರೆ ಯುನಿಟ್ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯನ್ನು ಮತ್ತು ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯನ್ ಅಂತ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಎರಡು ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ವಾಡ್ರಂಟ್ ಎರಡು ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಸೈನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ cos of minus x ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ cos x ಅಂತ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ರೀ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. So sine of minus theta, it will be minus sine theta, and cos of minus theta, it will be cos theta, whereas the tan of minus theta becomes minus tan theta. So these, you know, negative angles are going to be very important. Again, you will have to remember. Then which is the table that is left out now? Which is the table that is left out? It is 360 degree plus theta. See here, first quadrant. So this is 0 degree and 360 degree, and this is 90 degree. So in the 90 degree, in the first quadrant, we get 90 minus theta, 90 degree minus theta. This is one case. Then what is the other case? It has to be greater than 360. That is 360 degree plus theta, 360 degree plus theta. So we have to write the table for 360 plus theta now. Well, the next one, it has to be 360 plus theta. So see here, sine 360 degree plus theta, then cos 360 degree plus theta, then tan 360 degree plus theta, tan 360 plus theta, then secant 360 degree plus theta, then cosecant 360 degree plus theta, then cot 360 degree plus theta. So here we have 360 degree plus theta, 180 plus or minus theta, 360 degree plus or minus theta ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಇವು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು, ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಟ್ರಿಗ್ನೋಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸೈನ್. ಸೊ ಸೈನ್ 360 ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ. देन कॉस 360 डिग्री प्लस थीटा मीन इट इज कॉस थीटा अंदर फंक्शन चेंज आगबार्दु नमगे केस इद्दाग देन टैन 360 डिग्री प्लस थीटा इट विल बी टैन थीटा देन secant 360 degree plus theta it will be secant theta then 360 degree plus theta it will be cosecant 360 plus theta it will be cosecant theta then cot 360 degree plus theta it will be cot theta. Now think about the sign. Now think about the sign 360 plus. So 360 degree and this is 90 degree. 360 plus means it lies in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, all the six trigonometric ratios or functions will be positive. That means all these are positive. So we have to write plus sign, or you don't write anything, one and the same. So here I'll be writing plus sign. So it is plus. Yes, with this we have completed all the different cases. So 90 minus 90 plus or minus, 180 plus or minus, 270 plus or minus, and 360 plus or minus. So this concept is going to be very very important, and you will have to remember this. So bhaala janaku nimage confusion enadu andre idu bridge course athwa first pc syllabus anadu confusion dagidare. So ig maartta irodu ella enada mathematics enadu completely idu first pc syllabus ne, it is not bridge course. So be serious and make the notes, and if you have any doubts, you know, you can ask. Thank you.